Morning students, today I'm gonna teach 6th maths, knowing our numbers, continuation of the previous video. So today's topic is estimations. So estimating to the nearest tens by rounding off. Estimation means rounding off a number. So for example, if you have 22, so you have to round off this number 22 either to 20 or to 30. Okay, you have to round off 22 either to 20 or 30. There is a rule. You have to see how will you round. Now you have to round off either 20 or 30. No, so for which you will round off 20 or 30, that you have to see the unit place. In the unit place, if you have less than 5, so you will round off to the previous number 20. If you have more than 5, you will round off to 30. So less than 5 means round off to 20, more than 5 means round off to 30. Here less than 5, 22, so you will round off 22 to 20. You can see in this only you can understand 22 is nearer to 20, right, but far to 30. So from 21 to 24, it is nearer to what? 20, right? It is nearer to nearer to 20. And 25 to 29, it is nearer to 30, right? So you have to see which is nearer. Nearer you have to see if we you have to round off. Next, one more example, 732. Second example, 732. Now you have to round off to tens, right? So 32, you see. So for which I have to round off either to 730 or 740. 732 is nearer to which? Nearer to 730, right? Which is nearer? 732 is nearer to 730, right? 732 is not nearer to 740. It is so much of difference. Here only two numbers, 731, 732. Nearer, right? Here 8 733 34 35 36 37, so it is far. So this is near, so you will round off to 730. Understood? So you have to round off the to nearest tens. Next we will see round off to nearest 100. Rounding off to nearest 100. So next, how will you round off to nearest 100? Till now we studied what nearest tens, now nearest 100. Same way we have to see. Example 830. So this is a number they have given and asked you to round off to nearest 100. So it is 100, right? You have to see the tens place. If you have less than 50, you should round off to what? Less than 50 means you will round off to 800. More than 50 means you will round off to 900. So see what is this? Less than 50, right? So you will round off 830 to 800. All right, by seeing only you can see 830 is nearer to 800 but far to 900, right? So you will round off 830 to 800. What will you do if you have 850? So less than 50, greater than 50, I said less than 50 means 800, greater than 50 means 900. What you will do when it is exact 50? So 50 means you equal distance, right? It is nearer to 800, also nearer to 900. Distance is 50-50 numbers, right? 50 difference. 800 minus 850 is 50. 900 minus 850 is also 50. Distance is equal. So you can round off either to 800 or to 900. Most of the time we'll round off to 900. The greater number will round off. But If you round off to 800, it is also correct. Both is also correct, but most will refer to round off to 900 itself. Next, rounding off to thousands. Till now we studied rounding off to tens, hundreds. Now rounding off to thousand. So let me take one example: 2888. So when you are rounding off to thousand, what you have to do? So how can we round off this to? So to 1000 they said. So how will you? Either to 2000 you have to round off, or to 3000, right? It is here 2888. So either you have to round off to 2000 or the 3000. Remember, every time you have to see when they ask 1000, you have to see that 1000 which digit is there. If they have 2000, so you will round off to previous and the after number. So previous number is 2000 and after coming upcoming number is 3000. So now you have to see which is closer to this 2888, whether closer to 2000 or 3000. See the difference. So here difference is more, right? Here difference is less. 2888 is nearer to 3000. So you have to round off to 3000. Here also you can see by that method, if you have less than 500, you will round off to 2000. If you have greater than 500, you will round off to what? 3000. Understood? When you have 1000, you have to see the 100 place. So that time, if you have more than 500, 3000, less than 500 means the previous one. Okay? Remember it. If they ask for tens, rounding off for tens, you will see what? You will see the unit place. Unit place less than 5 and greater than 5. Okay. Then if they ask rounding off to 100, what you will see? What you will see? You will see the tens place. Tens place. What? Less than 50 and greater than 50. Then, if they ask to rounding off to 1000, what you will see? 100 place, right? 100 place you have to see. What is that observation you have to see? Less than 500 or greater than 500. So if you have less than 500, you will round off to the previous. If you have greater than 500, you will round off to the next number, which is for the question. If they have said it is in question is in 2888, the previous will be 2000. Next will be 3000, or else 5800. The previous will be 5000. Next will be 6000. Right. So previous number and after number you have to see. If you have so everywhere less than 5 means previous number, greater than 5 means the after number. So it depends upon the question. In the question you have to see previous number and after number. Let us solve one problem. The number is 75847. This is the number. Then approximate to nearest and rounded forms. Next, 75,847 approximate to nearer tens. If they ask, you have to approximate to nearest to tens. So tens means you have to see the unit place. So what is this? Greater than 7, greater than 5. So what you have to do? Round off to the next two. This is 47 now. So you have either 40 or 50 it comes. 40 or 50. So it is nearer to 50. So it will become what? 75,850. Understood? Next, round off to 100. The same number. We'll take the same number and do for everything. 10, 100, 1000. So now next you have to see 400. Round of 200. Round of 200 means which place you have to see? Tens, right? Two digits, tens and units together, right? So it is less than 50, right? Less than 50. And the previous number and after number for this is what? 800 and 900. So for which we have to round off? Less than 50 means the previous number, so 800 it becomes. So the answer will be 75,800. Next, round off to what? 1000. So how will you round off to 1000? Let me write it again. So round off to 1000 means you have to see the hundreds, right? Three digits. So this is what? Greater than 500. So greater than 500 means what you have to do? First we'll write the previous number and before number. One is 75,000, another one is 76,000, right? This is 75, right? 75 and 76. What will be the this is great nearer to which number? 76, right? Not nearer to. There's a lot of difference between 75,000 and 75,847, but less difference between 75,847 and 76,000. So we'll round off to 76,000, because also it is greater than 500. So round off to 76,000. Next one more is there. 10,000. Round off to 10,000. So how will you round off to 10,000 here? 847. The same number. 10,000 means you will see the thousands place. So what you have to do? If it is in this 10,000, if it is greater than 5,000 means you have to round off to the after number. Less than 5,000 means you have to round off to previous number. So what will be the previous number and after numbers for this? 10,000. Here 7 it is there. So previous number will be what? Previous number and after number. 70,000 or else 80,000, right? So given number, what they have said, 10,000, they have to see the 10,000's place. This is the unit, tens, hundred, thousand, 10,000. 10,000 place. One is the same number, 7,000, and the next 70,000 and the 80,000. So for which it is nearer, this or this? You have to see, or else this condition I said, greater than 5,000 and smaller than less than 5,000. See here, greater than 5,000, right? 5,847. So we'll round off to 80,000. So the answer will be 80,000. Student, take down this homework. Given number approximate to nearest rounded form. 36,246. You have to round off to tens, 100, 1000, 10,000. Students, do this homework in your homework book. Thank you.